Hello everyone, welcome to another video. I apologize for the just recent delays or late uploads because I've been experiencing technical issues in regards to the flight simulator installation manager. Because every time I try to upload, for example, like around 2.8 giga, I would resort to reaching a certain percentage, and then it would reset and then repeat the whole process again. And I'll show you what I'm talking about. So basically, around anything that exceeds 5.0 megabits per second, it would resort to resetting the whole download process, which been very tedious lately. That's why I wasn't able to upload much. But I recently figured out how to troubleshoot these issues. In my perspective or my technique, I looked up forums and such on how to bypass this issue. So as you're aware right now, this is what I've had to do to keep the process going. I had to set a certain download limit, so I resort to using a 3.5 maximum, nothing less and nothing more, because if it exceeds 5, it would once again, like I said, resort to resetting itself. So basically, it doesn't matter if you have a fast download, fast internet or whatever. That's just a bad thing, I guess, because it's on Microsoft's part. That's the issue. It's their fault. And whoever did this installation manager needs to have an immediate replacement, in my opinion. But anyways, I'll get to the point on how to bypass this issue if anyone else has the same issues I had before. So right now you're seeing, previously when I recorded this, I had to record it to test it out, which thankfully worked. And then you'll notice, I'm going to fast forward a little bit because it took me around more than 2 hours to download, like around 3 gigabytes, if you believe it or not. So here it's already closing in, like around, got a few more megabytes to go. But that's how it literally kept the same speed setting throughout the download process. So this is the application I used. That's called Net Limiter. I was provided in the link description below. So basically you go to this part of the screen, and you'll select this flight simulator, and then on this part you're going to see on your right side limit, and then in boxes that's where you want to check mark both of them, and then set the number to 3.5, which will automatically convert to kilobytes or kilobits, whatever the rate is. So this is what I set. It's up to you to play around the numbers. It's at your discretion, just as long as it doesn't exceed 5 megabits per second. So yeah, this is how I did mine. Hopefully this solution is very helpful for someone else that's experiencing this issue lately. And if there's any question, you can always inquire or leave a comment below. If you found this very helpful, leave a like and comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.